I'm starting by hydrating the face nicely with a gold tonic mist, which is going to leave the skin hydrated but also going to give it some dewy effect. And now I'm starting by moisturizing the face because my model has fairly dry skin. And if you can see, she has a lot of little mosquito bites. So during the color correction, I have also used a little bit of color corrector on these areas. Now I'm starting with a cream-based foundation. I'm using a cream-based foundation because I think that for this sort of a weather, it's best to have something that is strong and long-lasting, something that will not melt very easily. And now I'm just giving her face some more structure. She has a little bit of a flat structure around the cheeks, so extra contouring would not go wrong. And you can cover that up by using a cream blush. And you can see that right now it doesn't look all in place, but once it's all blended, it really comes in together. I'm just setting her base with loose powder, and now I'm starting the eyes. And for the eyes, I like to first highlight the underbrows and then start from transitioning the eyes. I want to start by applying a brown shade from the inner corner to the outer corner, and then I'm going to start making the outer corners slightly darker. I'm just using a little bit more eye base. You can even use your light shade concealers in the front because I'm going to be adding some color there. So I wanted to really show up and highlight, which cannot happen if I have brown at the back. For the green, I've used a liquid eyeshadow, which really worked well. Whenever you're using liquid eyeshadows, remember not to put powder on top. I think wing liners look really nice for Nikka looks. So here goes a sharp and thick wing liner. I'm doing the eyebrows, but if you see how I pack the lashes, it is on top of the eyeliner. My model had a little bit of droopy eyes, so to kind of give them a lift, I used the lash on top of the eyeliner. And I'm just highlighting her little mole so that it gives a complete look to her face. And adding some highlighter as well to complete the glow. Not too much, not too less. For her lips, we chose something which was not too dark, it was on the brown shade, but something that suited her skin tone and also complemented the rest of the makeup without stealing the show. The setting spray and the makeup is finished. This is how we have created this Nikka look, and I think she looks lovely. The blusher looks really nice, the eyes are striking, the lashes give a very mesmerizing and charming, dreamy effect. I hope you guys liked the look and enjoyed watching this video. Don't forget to like and share the video and subscribe to our channel for more such videos and more looks to come.